Have you ever been trying to walk to class and some random teacher throws a book at you that's educational but that you hate?
Oh my god, I want to
read this! Well, let's hear what that child had to say. Be quiet!
That hurt, ow.
Read this book!
Why, ow?
Because it's boring, it's educational, and because I said so!
No!
What?
No!
Let's go to class now!
I hate my wife. Ow.
Yes. Well, hello. My name is Sebastian. You know, a lot of parents have been complaining to the school board that their students aren't getting enough criteria in the books, when really, they are. The thing that they're lacking is interest. Now, nobody's heard of such a book that can be interesting and good for the school curriculum. But there is such a book. Now introducing the New York Times bestseller and winner of 1,000 million Academy Awards, 127 Hours Between a Rock and a Hard Place. A compelling book about a young man named Aaron Rolstein who goes on a surprise adventure to the Grand Canyon without telling any of his family except for leaving a note on his fridge. As he's there, he meets up with two girls, Megan and Kristen. These two girls, they share laughs, they become good friends with him, they go exploring, hiking, rock climbing, all that fun stuff. But Aaron wants to challenge himself, so he goes to one of the most dangerous caves there. But what he doesn't know is that that's gonna really change his life. As he's climbing, a horrible accident happens, which forces him to get his arm trapped under a giant boulder. He can't move it. All he can do is think and keep his courage up to stay in that position and survive. Now, while he's there, he relives all of his memories from the past, such as almost being attacked by a bear to climbing huge mountains. Now, I know what you're saying, Smash. There can't be any criteria. Literally, devices, hyperboles, irony, verbs, all that fun stuff. But I'll tell you something. There is. For example, picture all the imagery you could have. All he's talked about is all those beautiful scenes that he's been in. Oh, and the themes? Forget about it. The main theme here is for all teenagers. Stop believing in yourself and keep up that courage, and you will reach your goals. Now, since we're out of time, I'd love to show you a quick little sneak peek, because now this book is becoming a movie. So for all you readers that hate reading, you suck. But if you've read the book and you want to see a couple of moving pictures, go ahead and rent the movie. Now, here's a sneak peek. I'm Sebastian. Thank you very much.
Something chemical.
Chemical in your brain.
No! That makes us different from animals.
Makes us all the same.
I'm a guide. What do you say?
So the guidebook says that the route's through here, but I know a better way.
All you have to remember is that everything will be okay.
Oh my God! Aaron!
Aaron!
Yeah. You liked him.
I don't think we figured in his day at all.
Kristen! Help! Megan!
Mamma mia, here I go again. My, my, how can I resist ya?
Oh, hello. My name is Sebastian. You know, a lot of people have been complaining to the school board that, well, start over.
Make sure you don't get the food.
Oh my.
Oh. Well, I'm glad you considered reading the book and studying it. I'm also glad you watched the trailer to watch the movie. Now, one second, please. Slay!
I'm not afraid. Yeah. It's been a ride. Everybody. I guess I had to go to that place to get to this one. Now some of you might still be in that place. If you're trying to get out, just follow me. I'll get you there.
You can try and read my lyrics off of this paper before I lay them. But you won't take the sting out these words before I say them. Cause ain't no way I'm gonna let you stop me from...